Hello and welcome to our new series, Ethnosphere Behind the Scenes. I'm Matt.
And I'm Ethan. This series is designed for those who like to hear the techniques and stories behind every shot.
Today, we go back to Jervis Bay.
Take it away.
So before we get started, it's worth noting this side of the screen now looks a little bit darker. So anyone that's ever worked in any form of production would have gone through this. We literally have a downlight that's above us that was shooting the light down. It's just blown.
It's just blown and it's going to throw off the whole video. But
we're so sorry. We're so sorry. But nonetheless, we'll talk a bit about the Jervis Bay video. So it was the first video we released on the series. It was the premiere. It was the pilot. But we actually recorded it our third day of filming.
It was the third day of filming out. We shot two episodes beforehand, the figure 8 days one, which, as you know, if you watch our videos, didn't go according to plan.
Did not.
And the brewery video, which is a bit different to what we do. So we didn't want to launch that first because it would have thrown out the theme for our series.
And we felt like that Jervis Bay and the beaches that we're visiting has a very like general feel to it. And I think we even titled the series as a summer bucket list. So what's better than that for a summer bucket
Everyone
list?
Everyone loves a good day at the beach in summer.
So let's get this underway. Let's watch
Let's get it underway.
G'day. Welcome to today's episode of Ethnosphere Collective. We're going to be down on the south coast.
I like that shot. How it starts inside the boot of the car and then it comes up open, and that was a really cool way.
Yeah, it was something very interesting to do, working on transitions. As someone who's a photographer, you never have to worry about transitions or setting up a shot, but it was something that we had to learn, that I had to learn personally. Matt knew all about it.
Yeah, we actually got that from Casey Neistat, so anyone who sort of watched that, that's the style we're going for. I really love this intro where Ethnosphere Collective comes up for the first time and the music drops. I think that's just a really sweet moment when I made that, or when we edited it and put it together and looked at it, and I was like, wow, that hit me in the feels. Like, this is something that's happening.
Little known fact, Matt is the main editor for our channel. He does run things by me and just gives me a general idea of how the episodes are going to go out.
What time of the day was this, Caves Beach? I was in the morning, wasn't it?
It was about 11-ish or 12. We did get up quite early and it was a windy day at the beach, as you can hear from our audio.
Yeah.
So I'm just about so serene, just sitting on a rock, just looking at the ocean.
What was I doing here? You weren't here. You were off around the rocks here when we were shooting this. And I was just chilling there and I was like, oh, I need to get something for the video.
I was off climbing rocks and shooting stills.
Yeah, he was getting stills for us and I was like, all right, I'll get some videos. Cheeky little hint here. We're at Caves Beach, but this B-roll is from Hyams Beach.
It is a Jervis Bay episode. It's not the Cave Beach episode.
Yeah, it's not just a Caves Beach episode.
Were you itchy after you rolled around in the sand?
I was a little bit, but I was like, at the time of recording this, it was winter, obviously, in the northern hemisphere, and you see a lot of snow angels on Instagram, and I was like, no, we need an Australian one of this.
We do sand angels down on
there. Sand angels.
It's a bit funny, however. We rocked up vlogging to the cave on the beach, and there was these two guys in there playing chess or drafts or something like that.
Yeah, they were playing something in there, some tourists, and we're like, oh, we just walked in with a bunch of cameras just for recording, and they didn't really know what was going on. I don't think they even spoke English, so...
It was a bit awkward, but they were super nice about it.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
And even though they left, we kind of didn't ask them to.
Yeah, we did not force them out. We were just like, can we shoot in here? And they sort of like said, yes. I don't really think they understood what it meant, but... I love this part when we get inside the cave. How Australian do we sound?
Super bogan.
Ready?
It's fantastic.
How good is the natural lighting coming from the cave? Where...
Oh, tops. That's unreal. The lighting was really good in this cave, actually. Looking at that, that's really cool.
Yeah, it was excellent. Learning about lighting and things like that for filmmaking.
Yeah, that's something I have never really had to deal with myself. I've had some experience in terms of lighting with television studios and stuff, but I sort of been on the other side of it. I never really actually had to do it myself. It will work with it the behind the scenes kind of thing.
One thing to mention, how cinematic and gorgeous are the drone shots. It's a very unique perspective for photographers and videographers, and the technology is very cool.
Yeah, it's absolutely unreal. I love this shot. I think this was your idea. This is your sort of top down on the waves, where you have sort of the blue of the ocean, the sky blue of the whitewash and the water, and then the white sand. It's white sand at Hyams Beach because it's the whitest sand in the world. You know what was interesting about this part? Obviously this shot here isn't riveting or entertaining or such. We're literally inside a fish and chip shop.
getting fish and chips.
But as we said, this is our third day videoing, and this is a full fish and chip shop, and we just put out the cameras and we're just talking to it like easy. And a lot of people say, when doing these kind of videos where you actually have to talk to the camera, you feel so uncomfortable, and that is true.
It is true. Yeah. If you notice, I'm a bit awkward in some of the early videos, even some of the newer ones. I've never had a camera in my face before, like to film or to talk and act and actually be on camera is a lot different than just being yourself. Even though we try to be ourselves in these videos,
yeah,
there's definitely some sort of intimidation factor having a big barreled camera staring you down.
Yeah, and I've been in front of cameras a couple of times prior to this, but there's something just so awkward about holding an SLR in public and talking to it and everybody being like, well, what's this guy doing?
It's definitely something that draws attention if you take up a drone, pull out a big camera.
Yeah, the drones are just like that as well, isn't it? We're at like beaches. We actually got to Hymes Beach really early in the morning because we knew Hymes Beach is one of the most popular beaches in New South Wales.
It gets packed
and we're like, we need to get there before everybody gets there. Those people will just start freaking out and coming over and really getting into it. Some people might not like it, so... Yeah. Yeah,
a lot of people are a bit iffy on drones still. Fish and chips shop scene, definitely a bit awkward. Thanks for that, Matt.
No worries. Throw them in the deep end, that's how you learn. Interesting fact about this little B-roll segment while we're walking towards the ruined lighthouse. The tune that you're hearing now, wonderful song, but we were actually listening to Post Malone.
Yeah, a bit of Post Malone didn't go astray on our beach days. This scene was actually one of my favourite film personally. I had spent a little bit of time at Jervis Bay, Hymes Beach, Caves Beach, but I'd never been to the lighthouse lookout where the cliffs are just so jagged and drop off into the ocean. I'd never seen anything like that before.
This is one of the stupidest things I've ever done as a drone owner, I think. This shot looks good. I mean, it looks fine. It looks like, had I not said anything, you wouldn't have been able to tell. But it was so windy and I was terrified bringing that drone back down.
Yeah, it was quite difficult and we did do a lot of guiding, but the DJI drones are quite good. Sneaky plug, give us a free drone.
I know I'm talking about landing that drone in the video, so it's sort of like that in itself is a bit of a behind the scenes, but when we were landing that, we had to have so much coordination there. We were like, I think you were on the outside of that fence and you're like, bring it in closer. Cause it's hard to sort of judge your depth of field when you're moving a helicopter. It's literally a helicopter.
It is very stressful. It's a tiny helicopter.
And the wind's pushing it back and forth. And anyone that's flown a drone, when you land, if you don't catch it, you drop it straight to the floor. It has that moment where it sort of hits a certain level and it sort of stops because of the sensors. It needs to know if it's going to land or not. But then when it sort of has a split second where it just drops, and like the wind can just sort of take it, it'll sort of lose its stability. It was terrifying.
I was definitely worried we're going to lose that drone on the third day of filming. The first day we got to take it up, which was more stressful than anything.
That wasn't meant to be insulted into the ruined lighthouse in Jervis Bay. It is really pretty to see, but for us, the coast is just,
It's a bit of a heritage site, and as the name suggests, it is a ruined lighthouse. The
funny part about this shot is... the shot after this and the shot before it, they were two of the hardest to put together, to have the story flow logically. Our style is, I know a lot of people in this sort of genre of field, they like to shoot anything according, like however, and mix it together to make their own sort of story. We like to have our videos sort of chronological as the day goes. This is our journey to this destination. This is our time at the destination. So I try maintaining that, especially in our first episode, but the shot before this and the shot after didn't really gel, so I needed to find a shot that I had left over, which was this shot, and I do like it, but I didn't have the microphone turned on. So the audio you can hear on this shot is actually a mixture of different sound mixing that I had to download of waves that were recorded by someone else at a third party and wind, and I combined them.
Hey, I didn't even know that.
Yeah.
Sneaky.
Yeah, 100%. It did not have any audio, so I had to try and like make it blend.
Seems like it does actually lap well with the rocks, so...
Yeah. It does sound really natural. I was stoked when I heard it. I was like, oh, that's pretty cool.
The
Baywatch moment. It was cool when we recorded it, but, like, looking it back at it, when that moment where it goes from fast motion to slow motion, and the run... It was actually quite a long run.
Yeah, it was probably, like, 30, 40, 50 meters down the beach.
And that little, so much fun. And that little girl just turns and does, like, the full stare as we're running, and everybody... Oh, this is cool.
then a big time-lapse sequence. I don't know if you can tell, but me and Matt were actually out in the waves brawling.
We were brawling. That's it, we were out in the waves and we were having a bit of a tackling match with each other and who got the better here?
It was me, definitely, with these guns.
Yeah. And then we have at the end of the video the ending shot of the drone going along Hyams Beach. Very similar to the first shot, but it just looks really cinematic and a nice little high five.
A slow-mo high five to end the video.
Yeah. Rewatching that was... So how many times have you watched that episode before?
A lot.
A lot, but like when was the last time you watched it?
Yesterday.
Yesterday?
When my mum put it on.
Oh, okay, right. I haven't watched that episode in its entirety in a few weeks, and I was like, it's kind of a nice little episode. That episode, watching that then, it had me smiling all the way through, and it's filled with memories, like what we were just talking about.
Yeah, there were some crazy times and just mind-blowing things that we saw and did, and it's probably something we'll remember for the rest of our lives.
Yeah.
Jervis Bay truly is a unique and beautiful place here on the south coast of Australia. And if you're going to go, bring some friends. You'll have a great time.
That's not just with Jervis Bay, with any adventure you go on, because that's what it's all about. Just bring your friends along. As you can see in Ethnosphere's videos, we have a lot of features because at the end of the day, we like making films, we like taking photos, and we like spending time with friends. So
that's what it's all about at the end of the day.
Cool. Thanks, guys, for watching this new series that we're going to try out. It's a bit of a director's cut kind of thing that we like to talk about what happened, what was going through our thoughts, what was going through our process in our head. When we're like, oh, this would be a cool shot kind of thing. So
let us know what you think, guys. All the feedback does help, and we do listen to all of it and take it on board.
Yeah, the sport's been really humbling. So once again, thank you guys for watching. Like, share, subscribe, all of that jazz, because it really does help.
Thanks, guys. Have a good one.
Catch you later. Okay.